As the clock ticks down and the fate of humanity hangs in the balance, one man stands at the forefront of a mission to save us all. Elon Musk, the visionary entrepreneur and CEO of SpaceX, has a dream: to colonize Mars and make humanity a multi-planetary species. For two decades, his multi-billion dollar company has been working towards this goal, driven by the belief that we need a plan B if Earth becomes irreversibly damaged through climate change, overpopulation, or other catastrophic events. But now, a new concern has emerged. In January, Musk tweeted about the possibility of population collapse on Earth, raising the question of whether there'll be enough people to make his Mars colonization plan a reality. According to a study published in The Lancet, the global population may decrease after the second half of the century, a stark contrast to previous projections by the United Nations. Despite these challenges, Musk remains unwavering in his determination to colonize Mars. With successful rocket systems like the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy, and plans to send humans to the Red Planet as early as 2024 with the Starship, he's leading the charge towards a future where humanity is not confined to one planet. The stakes are high, and the road ahead will be rocky, but Musk is ready to take on the challenge. Can he turn his dream into a reality and secure the future of humanity? Only time will tell. The good and bad sides on decrease of population. As the world stands at the brink of a population collapse, the consequences of such a decline could be both good and bad. On the positive side, a decrease in population could bring much-needed relief to the environment, with fewer people consuming fewer resources and generating fewer carbon emissions. However, it's important to note that this alone is not a solution to the pressing issue of climate change. Meanwhile, some countries like Japan, Spain, and Ukraine could see their populations cut in half, or more, by 2100, while China is predicted to fall from its current 1.4 billion people to roughly 700 million. But not all countries will experience a decline in population. The models predict that sub-Saharan Africa, North Africa, and the Middle East will be the only regions with a higher population in 2100 than in 2017. In high-income Western European countries, the population's expected to reach its peak much earlier than the global peak in 2064, leading to significant economic consequences, such as lower GDP growth rates and challenges for public health and pension programs. A smaller workforce could also have major fiscal implications, but immigration could help to mitigate these effects. On the other hand, countries that are able to maintain their working population through immigration, like Canada, Australia, and the United States, may prosper in the face of these challenges, while these predictions are based on current understanding of population indicators, and may not necessarily be accurate, they do provide insight into potential future trends and the potential consequences of a population collapse. The future is uncertain, but one thing is clear: the decisions we make today will have a major impact on the world of tomorrow. Why is colonization needed? Elon Musk, founder of SpaceX and Tesla, believes that the colonization of Mars is crucial for the survival of the human species in the event of a third world war. During a recent appearance at South by Southwest, Musk stated that a self-sustaining base on Mars would be more likely to survive a global conflict than a moon base, and would serve as a seed of human civilization to rebuild and shorten the potential dark ages that could follow. To achieve this goal, SpaceX is developing the BFR, or Big Fucking Rocket, a 100-meter spacecraft intended to transport humans to Mars. However, Musk acknowledged that establishing a colony on the Red Planet would require, quote, tremendous entrepreneurial resources, and would not be for the faint of heart, comparing it to the dangerous and challenging expeditions of Antarctic explorer Ernest Shackleton. Musk also addressed the possibility that Mars colonization could become an escape route for the wealthy, saying that the risks of the mission would likely deter most people from wanting to go, at least initially. He added that over time, the Mars colony would become more hospitable and even have great bars. The BFR is set to make its first flight in the first half of 2019, though Musk admitted that his timelines have historically been optimistic. In addition to discussing the potential for Mars colonization, Musk also expressed concern about the dangers of unregulated artificial intelligence, which he's previously warned could lead to a third world war. He suggested the creation of a public regulatory body with insight and oversight to ensure that AI is developed safely and in a way that benefits humanity. Musk proposed that rather than aiming to maximize human happiness, digital intelligence should be directed towards maximizing the freedom of action of humanity. In the meantime, SpaceX has many milestones to go before Starship can carry passengers. The rocket has yet to reach orbit. Musk last year said that the company will fly hundreds of missions with satellites before we put people on board. Musk may be focused on Mars, but the hurdles of Starship's development are not lost on the space billionaire. It's a tough vehicle to build because we're trying to crack this nut of a rapid and fully reusable rocket, Musk said. But the thing that's really important to revolutionize space is a rapidly reusable rocket that's reliable too. Interplanetary profit. Despite the many challenges and uncertainties that lie ahead, SpaceX and its founder Elon Musk remain committed to the idea of establishing a human settlement on Mars. The company's currently in the early stages of developing its Starship rocket and spaceship system, which is intended to ferry cargo and people across the vast distance between Earth and Mars. However, the development of this technology is expected to be a lengthy and costly process, with Musk estimating that it could take up to $10 billion to complete. In order for a Mars settlement to be viable, a number of significant technological and logistical challenges will need to be overcome. For example, settlers will need to find a way to protect themselves from the toxic air and deadly radiation that exists on the surface of the planet. In addition, the economic situation on Mars is likely to be precarious for at least the first 100 years of human presence there, according to Michael Meyer, the lead scientist for NASA's Mars Exploration Program. One possible solution that's been proposed is the concept of terraforming, which involves the attempt to make Mars more Earth-like by introducing greenhouse gases into its atmosphere in order to make it thicker, warmer, and more hospitable to life. While this idea has been promoted by Musk and is ingrained in SpaceX's culture, given the limited resources available on Mars and the extremely resource-intensive nature of the process, ultimately, it may be necessary to rely on advanced alien technology or other creative solutions in order to establish a successful human settlement on Mars. Why Mars? At an average distance of 140 million miles, Mars is one of Earth's closest habitable neighbors. Mars is about half again as far from the Sun as Earth is, so it still has decent sunlight. It's a little cold, but we can warm it up. Its atmosphere is primarily CO2, with some nitrogen and argon and a few other trace elements, which means that we can grow plants on Mars just by compressing the atmosphere. Gravity on Mars is about 38% of that of Earth, so you would be able to lift heavy things and bound around. Furthermore, the day is remarkably close to that of Earth. Starship. On May 5, 2021, SpaceX successfully completed its fifth high-altitude flight test of a Starship prototype from its facility in Texas. The Starship, designated serial number 15, or SN15, was powered by three Raptor engines during ascent, which shut down in sequence before the vehicle reached its highest point, approximately 10 kilometers in altitude. SN15 then transitioned to using its internal header tanks, which contain landing propellant, before flipping itself around for re-entry and a controlled descent back to the ground. During its descent, the Starship used its onboard flight computer to actively control its altitude through the movement of four flaps on the vehicle. The engines on SN15 reignited as it performed a landing flip maneuver just before touching down on the designated landing pad. These test flights are an important step in the development of a fully reusable transportation system, capable of carrying both crew and cargo on long journeys to destinations such as the Moon and Mars. The team at SpaceX should be congratulated for the successful flight and landing of SN15. The first stage, or booster, of our next-generation launch system has a gross liftoff mass of over 3 million kilograms and uses subcooled liquid methane and liquid oxygen, or CH4LOX, propellants. The booster will return to land at the launch site on its six legs. The Starship payload fairing is 9 meters in diameter and 18 meters high, resulting in the largest usable payload volume of any current or in-development launcher. This payload volume can be configured for both crew and cargo. Landing on Mars. Starship will enter Mars's atmosphere at 7.5 kilometers per second and decelerate aerodynamically. The vehicle's heat shield is designed to withstand multiple entries, but given that the vehicle is coming into Mars's atmosphere so hot, we still expect to see some ablation of the heat shield, similar to wear and tear on a brake pad. What is Starbase? Starbase is a spaceport, production, and development facility located in Boca Chica, Texas, United States, that was built by SpaceX, an American aerospace manufacturer, in the late 2010s and 2020s. The facility was designed to provide SpaceX with an exclusive launch site that would allow the company to accommodate its launch manifest and meet tight launch windows. The launch site was originally intended to support the launch of Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets, as well as other reusable suborbital vehicles. However, in early 2018, SpaceX announced that the launch site would be used exclusively for its next-generation launch vehicle, Starship. Between 2018 and 2020, the site added significant rocket production and test capacity.